Fourth Standard 6. Today we are going to learn Chapter 5, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, Part 2. We have seen in Part 1 that Huckleberry was a beggar-born boy. He was always roaming with his friend Tom Sawyer. And one day they found a big box of jewelry. They divided it and Huck took his share and gave to Judge Thatcher to invest. He was sent to Mrs. Douglas to take care, and Mrs. Douglas was interested in his education. She wanted him to educate and make a proper citizen. She used to make him to pray, eat in timely, eat with spoon and forks, everything she was teaching, which Huck did not like it. He wanted to have his total freedom, so one day he ran away because he don't wanted to stay in rule and regulation. And as he was outside roaming, his father met him. He was called as Puck. Puck is Huckleberry's father. He was a really cruel father. He wanted only money from him. He kidnapped Huck and took him to the woods where his cabin was there. He locked him inside and Puck went to the city. Huck was alone and frightened. He managed to get a small knife and he opened the door, went to the woods, brought a wild pig and killed it and put the blood all around the cabin and outside also. Like wild animal has dragged him, killed him. And he escaped to the Jackson's Island by a small boat. When he reached there, he found a ship around the Mississippi River. And as he saw, he understood his father, George Thatcher, Mrs. Watson, and Mrs. Douglas, were there, and they were shooting cannon in the water so that their dead body can come. Huck certain time felt bad that they were in a trouble searching for him, but same time he was happy that he is now in total freedom. He don't need to obey anybody and he can do as he like. Dear student, now we see in the part 2 that Huck has reached to the Jackson's Island. He found a place where he could cook something. He made a fire and he cooked catfish and he had his meal. After some relaxation, he went around to explore the Jackson's Island. He found somewhere little smoke, so he got scared and he said, "I am not the only in this island, somebody more living." And he got frightened and climbed on a tree. He remained on the tree for 2 hours and he found nowhere. He came down. As he came down, an other man who was sleeping, he got up. He saw that he was the Jim, Mrs. Watson's slave. And Jim saw Huck and Jim got frightened. He said, "You, Huck, have died. How do you come here? You are a spirit." Huck said, "No, Jim, I am not a spirit. I am Huck, who is not dead. I am not a dead. I am just here alive and I played a trick to escape from my pap and my Mrs. Douglas. I am here as alive." Jim was not sure. He was frightened. And Jim, Huck asked Jim, "Why are you here? Mrs. Watson was very good lady. She took care of you and you had a family." Then he said, "It is not that she did not take care of me, but one day I heard she wanted to sell me to somewhere the people in Orleans down the river and for $800, which I did not like to be sold. So I ran away. Actually, I wanted to go to Illinois, but it is too far for me. That is a land which is banned for slavery. Slave people are not allowed to be there. So I wanted to be there, but I could not go. So I am in Jackson's Island. But how do you come here?" So he explained that, "I wanted to escape from my pub," and he narrated how he escaped. Meanwhile, while they were talking, heavy rain poured and Mississippi River was fully filled and there were many logs floating in the river. Jim and Huck went and cut off some logs and they made a canoe, and with that they went in the water. Then they saw a house is floating. They went with their canoe to the river where the house was floating, and they found in that there were some silver coin, gold coin, and also few dresses of girls. Jim took that and Huck started to wear. He was a small boy, so he was looking very beautiful girl, and they planned that to wear this disguise in this dress and go to the city and find out what is happening there. And Huck went to the city in disguise. Children, this is the lesson part 2 we have learned. Now you learn your home word meaning as a homework, and also this lesson you read and revise. Thank you.